let's talk about something called the morning pages. So Brian Koppelman is the creator of a TV show called Billions. And every morning he sits down with a cup of coffee and writes three handwritten pages that are effectively just a stream of his consciousness. Now, he didn't invent the concept. It was created, I believe, by someone named Julia Cameron, but he did kind of popularize it. And it's a very, very great way to take notes using the daily format, which I will talk about in a second. But in this video, I want to walk through what are the morning pages, how to do them, and take it a step further to talk about some things that you can do with those pages and give you some tips for consistency. But let's first dive in. Let me talk about exactly what the morning pages are. So like I said, the morning pages are a practice of writing three pages of longhand stream of consciousness writing, and you do it first thing in the morning. This is a fairly old concept, so it predates digital note-taking apps, I believe, and traditionally was done through handwriting. And now you can adapt it to your note-taking app and really use whatever tool you use for note-taking. But it's not really about creating a polished, thoughtful piece of writing. It's more about clearing your mind and unleashing your creativity. So that's what Brian Koppelman says. It's the perfect way to set yourself up to unleash your creativity, your energy, and your thoughtfulness for the day. It helps also in silencing that internal critic, clearing your mental clutter, solving personal and professional problems, and, you know, even just reducing stress and anxiety. So it's actually a mental health tactic in addition to helping boost your creativity. So a ton of benefit. So let's now talk about how to actually do the morning pages. So right after you wake up, sit down with your note-taking tool. Now, like I said, the old way was to write three pages of handwritten notes. But there's a couple different ways that we can do this to adapt it to the digital age. So we could do it by word count. Three handwritten pages is usually around 750 words for a normal person who can type. Or that's about 20 to 30 minutes if you're pausing to actually think about some things, not just sort of like hammering it on the keyboard. But I think the easiest way is just to transcribe an audio note. Walk around outside, around your house for 5 to 10 minutes, just speaking, and that is your literal stream of consciousness. I think that's the easiest way to record it. And you're going to write whatever comes to your mind. It can be mundane. It can be trivial. It can be significant. It might not even make sense. Whatever you feel like you need to regurgitate from your mind onto the page, that's what this is for. The key is to not overthink it or to really even edit what you write at all. Just let your thoughts flow freely. So if you sit down and you genuinely have no idea to write, just start by writing or saying, I have no idea to write, what to write, and start rambling. You'll probably find that the stream of consciousness will start flowing naturally. Okay, so what do you do with the pages after you have them? So you've sat down, you've taken these notes each morning. What do you do with them? Well, the nice thing about the daily note format is that you actually don't have to do anything with them. And that is sort of the original concept of the daily pages. They're not specifically to review. It's not a task list. It's not something that is part of a defined workflow. So it's really just about the therapeutic act of writing or regurgitating your thoughts onto a page. So I guess that's the short answer. You don't have to do anything with them. And I did want to make a note here on physically writing. I think there's a lot of people who will say that a lot of the benefit in this comes from actually just doing the physical handwriting. Now, I get that. I know that there are a lot of cognitive benefits of physical handwriting. I still use a physical notebook myself for brainstorming and stuff sometimes. But for this concept here, I actually think it's much easier to record a stream of my consciousness when I'm speaking, even better than typing. I can think so much faster than I write or type. And so I get frustrated when there's things I want to record and I feel like I can't write or type fast enough to record what's happening in my head. So there's pros and cons. You might decide to write yours. And if you do, that's honestly fine. You could always take a picture of it and upload it to your notes just so that you have a recording of it. But there are some things that you can do with them. So if you wanted to, you could review them as needed or as desired. I actually like looking back mostly just for fun. I could talk myself into thinking that it's some productivity thing, but really it's just quite interesting to look back a year, several years ago, and see what you were thinking on any given day. And I should note that adding backlinks will help here if you're using a network note-taking tool. And, you know, Reflect obviously has a AI prompt that will automatically add the backlinks for you. So you can select text and it will go through. Probably doesn't work on that one because I don't have any entities there. But that will just help you organize it. And that's honestly what I do with these. I just leave them in my daily notes. That's another benefit of the daily notes format. If you wanted to, you could do some formatting and stuff with them. So for example, you could go into your templates and add maybe a morning page of template, and maybe it's just going to be, you know, a bullet. Maybe I want a backlink. Morning pages in my demo brain here. And then underneath it is just going to be my actual stream of consciousness. And that's it. That can be my template so that if I go into, you know, my daily note here for Tuesday, I can just type morning pages and either start typing or recording or whatnot. Now, additionally, if I've, you know, got a big block of text like this, maybe if I'm going to do it with voice notes, I want to set up some kind of simple format with a custom AI prompt where it just does this automatically. But to be honest, it's not any kind of complex formatting, so I usually just type out the morning pages. Okay. And then finally, so this is actually quite fun. You could chat with your morning pages. If you were to do them for a while and say, you know, add a backlink like I did, or, you know, maybe actually, did I record one? I think I did a sample here. So if I take this audio note, another thing you could do is give it a hashtag. So you could say morning pages, and then let's pretend I took this audio note and I'll put that under there. And then if I, oops, I didn't create a tag out of that. There you go. And then if you wanted to, let's say you've been doing this every day. So I, of course, just have one here, but I could go into search and add the morning pages tag. And so if you imagine you have all of your notes here, this is just my demo brain, but I could actually go start chatting with them. And you could, you know, ask how you were feeling on a certain day, what's happening in your brain, maybe some mental health tips to help you. I don't know, tips for unlocking your creativity. You can actually kind of chat with your brain. It's very fun. Okay. So finally, I'm just going to give some tips for consistency here. So one, make a habit out of it. Do it every single day, preferably at the same time each morning. I think a lot of people wake up in the morning and you don't necessarily want to open your email right away, or, you know, the annoying messages that you might have to deal with or something. So this, honestly, much like a morning journal, is just a very pleasant way to start your day. It's very, very therapeutic. So do it every day. Make it a habit. Don't worry about spelling, grammar, or punctuation. Just write. Again, it doesn't even have to make sense. That's not really the point of this. And if you can't think of anything, like I said earlier, just start repeating, I can't think of what to write, until something comes up. Now, I guess the biggest tip I should add here is just to use audio notes. So if you use the audio note, it's just so much easier to do. I can just come in here and click this button, start recording. I can just use the widget on my phone if I'm making coffee or breakfast or something, and just record my morning pages as I go about my morning. I promise it's one of the most enjoyable things that you can add to the start of your day. And you're going to start feeling the mental, creative, cognitive benefits start compounding very quickly.